Calling Duchess Kate the pride of the British royal family would not be an overestimation. In an unprecedented year that was still under the shadows of COVID-19 pandemic, the Duchess of Cambridge managed to give us not one or two but 12 moments in the last 12 months that will be remembered in the history books. In January 2021, the Duchess of Cambridge shared her first ever selfie video to mark the Children's Mental Health Week. Catherine recorded the video on her mobile phone during her daily morning run at Anmer Hall, where she was living at that time. March 2021 saw the Duchess of Cambridge bringing a new set of style that later on became one of her signature styles, a long coat and a matching sweater with long trousers. Ahead of their 10th wedding anniversary, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge visited Westminster Abbey. Although the couple had visited the venue of their wedding many times in the last decade, this time the visit had special vibes, with the Duchess wearing ivory-white Catherine Walker Valeria coat with Anushka pearls and Kiki Mogdano hoops. Recreating their engagement photoshoot moment, William and Catherine posed for two photographs in the gardens of Kensington Palace to mark their 10th wedding anniversary. Keeping her look simple but extremely stylish and chic, the Duchess chose to bring the Ghost Every wrap floral dress from the Royal Tour of Pakistan back, this time teaming up with Esprit London's Daisy Diamond Bandit Necklace. The outfit once again highlighted her sapphire and diamond engagement ring. In the month of May, the Duchess of Cambridge launched the Hold Still 2020 book. Kate chose a stunning red Epony London coat with a still unknown top and Zara camel pleated belted midi skirt. The stylish outfit was an immediate hit, giving her evening style a Scottish touch. During the Scotland tour, the Duchess of Cambridge chose Holland Cooper full-length Mark Rowe trench coat with Joseph metallic knit skirt that she teamed up with another new royal piece of jewelry, Queen's Dubai looped sapphire dummy pearl. June saw the Duchess of Cambridge touching the milestone moment of her early years project when she launched the Royal Foundation Centre for Early Childhood. For the landmark launch, Kate chose to pay a tribute to her own early years of royal life and picked an L.K. Bennett dress. The brand was a big part of Catherine's early royal wardrobe and still has a huge presence in her closet. In September of 2021, the Duchess of Cambridge showed the world why she is an uncrowned queen of the royal fashion world. She joined Prince Charles, Duchess Camilla, and Prince William at the world premiere of James Bond's new movie No Time to Die, wearing a show-stopping golden Jenny Peckham gown that was part of the label's special collection created to mark the 60th anniversary of James Bond series. Catherine paired the new gown with her Onita London gold-plated earrings, Ekusara pumps, and Ufo citrine ring. On the next day, the Duchess of Cambridge joined Prince William for a day-long visit to Northern Ireland, and her style was a complete 360 from the previous night outfit when she chose a vibrant purple Amelia Wickstead suit. October saw the Duchess of Cambridge making an extremely elegant appearance at the first ever Earthshot Awards night, where the Duchess chose to rescue her 10-year-old Alexander McQueen gown that she first wore in July 2011 during the North America tour. That was her first ever international tour as a royal. Catherine was not done yet with us giving show-stopping glamour. At the Royal Variety Performance in November, we saw a stunning reappearance of green glittering Jenny Peckham number from the Pakistan tour. This time, giving it a glamorous touch with side-swept hair, Duchess stole the night away with matching accessories and Mizoma London earrings. The Duchess of Cambridge chose to end the year with a royal yet artistic touch. We have always known Kate is a thorough artistic person, and this winter we saw her another talent. Music. The Duchess of Cambridge joined Tom Walker at the Chapter House of Westminster Abbey for a heartwarming duet performance in which Catherine played piano while Tom performed his new Christmas song. The performance was part of the Together at Christmas Carol service that the Duchess of Cambridge hosted at Westminster Abbey to honor those who worked hard during the pandemic to serve the community. And as I always say, this is just the beginning. Let's see what the new year will be bringing. I wish all of you a very happy new year. Stay tuned for more royal news.